Happy New Year! Did you set any New Year's resolutions for yourself? I did. I set three. The first is no more grinding games. If the game feels like work, I'm out. I'm looking at you, Transformers Tactical Arena. That's why there's a near 30-minute video of me opening crates on Fotix TV. I was trying to make a point. Star Trek Legends is sadly in this category too. Leveling up characters in that game, when you have over 70 of them, can be extremely tedious. Fortunately, I'm almost done with that game, so I'll keep playing it, somewhat. Actually, I've been looking for a new game. If you clicked on this video, perhaps you too are looking for a new game to play. I suppose this is a good moment to mention my second New Year's resolution, because when you hear the third goal, you might think that I'm giving up on Fotix TV. Nope, that's not my plan. I am having way too much fun making these videos. Things are just getting started here. Hopefully you like these videos too. So, with that said, the goal is to hit 1,000 subscribers this year. The problem there is that even 1,000 subscribers is not a lot of money. It takes time to grow a YouTube channel. So, I need another project while Fotix TV catches on. The best Fotix TV videos are about Crossy Road, and Hipster Whale doesn't release new content every day. That leads to the third goal. I was stuck inside on New Year's Day, as it was cold and rainy in New York City. So, I started thinking about what big plan I should try to accomplish this year. I've been thinking about creating a game for Apple Arcade, as Apple Arcade made 2021 a very fun year. I haven't played so many good games like that in decades. But there's a problem. It's not easy to make a good video game. That's when I decided to look at the top performing games on Apple Arcade. Surprisingly, Apple doesn't let you search the games by rating. Actually, when looking at the games in a web browser, Apple doesn't even show the ratings. Even worse, Apple doesn't even have an easy way to search the Apple Arcade games. Apple says that there are over 200 games, but how many are there exactly? So I decided to write down each one. That's ironic. I gave up on playing tedious video games, only to immediately start a tedious video game project. So, for several hours, over 2 days, I wrote down the information about every Apple Arcade game available in the United States on an iPad. There were some differences between a Mac, Apple TV, and mobile. In other words, this video is mainly about iOS, as there are differences with Apple Arcade on macOS and tvOS. Even though this project was not fun, I learned a lot. First, I counted 222 games for Apple Arcade. That's more than I thought. Even more surprisingly, there are more big-name developers than I thought. While I had seen games from Konami and even Sega, I didn't know Capcom, Ubisoft, and other developers were there too. Apple and friends are really building something nice. So, what's the best of the best? To find out, I sorted the list by the number of ratings, and then by the average rating score. One other thing, I only counted the games with at least 10,000 ratings. Again, these ratings are what was shown on the iPad during the start of the new year. Also, if the game ended in a plus, it was excluded from the list. While I like that Apple Arcade prohibits in-app purchases and advertisements, that's not enough for me to want to replay an old game. As an example, Tiny Wings Plus scored high with an average rating of 4.8. However, it's basically the same game. I already have it. The only main difference with Apple Arcade is that I can play Tiny Wings Plus on my Apple TV. That's nice, but that's not what I consider the best of the best on Apple Arcade. Another example is Solitaire by MobilityWare Plus. It also has an average rating of 4.8. with 23,000 ratings. But it's Solitaire. I was playing that on Windows in the 90s. It was included with my computer. If that makes you angry, don't worry. Neither of those games made the top 5 anyway. I'm not saying they're not good games. They are. But they're not what makes Apple Arcade, Apple Arcade. I think that the top 5 games listed in this video do portray the best of the best of Apple Arcade. So, here we go. Number 5, Song Pop Party. With an average rating of 4.8 and with 25,000 votes, Song Pop Party claims the fifth spot. It's a music game that I probably would not have played otherwise. It's super cute. Basically, it's a quiz about popular songs. You can play against the computer or with other people. It's a good party game. There were some nice events in the game recently too, like the Christmas event and the New Year's event. Number 4, Skate City. I just started playing this game recently. Wow, it's a lot of fun. With an average score of 4.8 and with 29,000 votes, obviously lots of other people like the game too. There was a review on this game recently on Fodix TV, so I'll keep this summary short. It's a skateboarding game with nice music and beautiful sunsets. It's simply a well-made game, and if you just play for fun, not for score or clearing objectives, it's relaxing. But if you like a certain degree of difficulty in your games, this one can be challenging too. Number 3, The Oregon Trail. I haven't actually played this one. I didn't even play the original. I only know this game by the meme. You have died of dysentery. Yet the numbers, they speak for themselves. With a score of 4.8 and 32,000 votes, it's clearly a popular game on Apple Arcade. Since I am looking for another game to play, The Oregon Trail does look interesting. What do you think? Are you interested in a review from Fodix TV about The Oregon Trail? At number 2, What the Golf? The game at the second spot is something that I have played, although only recently. What the Golf is a parody of the popular sport, but it's also a mishmash of comedy too. With a rating of 4.9 and 18,000 votes, people seem to enjoy this game a lot. Although, I wasn't laughing hysterically while playing this game. It's more about puns, along with spoofs, on popular video games and pop culture. What I found interesting about this game is the level design. That's really good. Except those first-person levels. Ugh, serious motion sickness there. It felt like I was playing a 3D game from the 90s. Also, wow, that last level is super creepy. That was an unexpected turn. Are you interested in a full review of this game? I beat the main campaign and the sports levels, so I know a lot about what's good and what's not so good about the game. At number 1, it's Sneaky Sasquatch. I haven't played this game either, but it's clearly the most beloved Apple Arcade game, as it has an average rating of 4.9, and it has 85,000 ratings, which is the most votes on an Apple Arcade game by far. So, that's the top 5 Apple Arcade games. However, that's not the main reason why I made this list. I wanted to see what works and what doesn't work on Apple Arcade, as that's related to my third New Year's resolution. I'm aiming to make a game for Apple Arcade. Now, Apple decides what they want to release on their service. That's expected, but this information helps me to minimize the chance that Apple will reject my game. So what do you think? Are you interested in a series of videos about making a video game specifically for Apple Arcade? If you are, you can let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching.